And good afternoon, everybody. This is Michael Filigera. I am with logicalsignals.com and also tradershelpingtraders.com. And this is the Elliott Wave update for the NASDAQ 100 for Wednesday, May 19th, 2021. Well, as I came in this morning, I was very pleased. I thought, okay, we're heading lower on that C wave. We're going to go down. We're at least going to get down to some support levels down below, thinking maybe 12,750-ish around in that area. And then the U.S. session opened, and it was like, no, not going to happen. And they spent the first 4.5 hours buying the market, just buying the market. And at first I thought, okay, you know, this comes down 3, maybe we get a little 4. Now, as soon as it went up over this level, this one, come on. 13,182.75, nope. And in fact, if it had gone up and come back down and closed below it, then we may have allowed it to be a 4 and then nosedive from there. But the fact that it did come up, closed above that level, wave 4 overlaps wave 1, and that's a rule. And it broke a rule that because it cannot overlap wave 1, it broke the rule, negating that particular count that I was using, as if this was 1, 2, 3, and that doesn't work. So what it ends up being is the alternate that we had, and that this was A, and now was going to go and complete the B wave. And again, this is for that, this whole structure is going to be a B wave. It's going to be an A, a B, and a C. And we had felt yesterday, in fact, I left it and gave the alternate as the fact that if it doesn't come down and start breaking down support levels and then swings and goes back up, then what we've had is 1, 2. So the fact that it broke below this level on the way down gave more credence. It's like, oh, okay, so it's a third. The fact that it didn't come back up and again broke above that level even negated that. So all of the previous thoughts and account have all been negated simply by the market. So once again, we continue to allow the market to tell us where it's going and what is it tracing out. And so by doing that, we hopefully will be on the right foot. But as I've also stated, when the market started to rally, it's not a matter either you can sit it out because it's not exactly what you were looking for this morning, or you trade it because that's what's in front of you. And so you just continue to trade it again, using moving averages, using some Fibonacci intraday, using the basic, if it starts breaking rules of Elliott, then you could get even a cleaner idea that where this thing is going to go. And so in fact, you know, the high today was just below that. So it was about, I think, 13,243. Well, if the rule was broken at 82, was it? Yeah, at 83. And it continued to go, well, that gave plenty of opportunity where you knew just to approach from the buy side. But even in here, these breaks above these moving averages and the moving averages now going in sync to go up, they're not quite there, but they certainly were all hooking. The 20s hooking, the 4s hooking, the 8s hooking, and even the 50s kind of gone flat. But in any case, we were getting signals from the market that they were going to take it even higher. So you make it, you change, you go with it and not fight it, you go with it. And that's a key point that I want to make here, because often in my own trading history, I've made a decision in my mind for whatever reason, the market's wrong and I'm right and you should be going down or you should be going up and I'm going to do the opposite. Well, guess who wins in the end? More times than not, my friends, it's always going to be the market, because we have to assume that the market is always accurately priced and trading perfectly, trading to according to what the participants and what the movement is showing us. So do we have false breakouts? Of course. Do we have breakouts down that are false? Of course. These will continue to happen. But overall, if you stay in tune with your moving averages and what is in front of you, you should, not that it always happens, but you should, if you're down, you should be able to recover and make money because you're continuing to trade. You're continuing to attempt to follow the market. Now, I will be honest in that there were many points this morning. This was just pure chop. And the market was not really even making clear what its full intent was, that it was just going to continue to go up and that the buy orders were going to be stronger and just keep pushing, because it just kind of would go up and fail, go down, go up and fail, go down. So it ended up being in boxes that kind of got bigger as the morning wore on, even though it eventually, if you're looking at this hourly chart, it just went up. So, but trading it intraday, it was not an easy day. Let me put it that way. And I know people that really kind of lost a lot of money today because they were in touch with me. And many negative things happening. So again, as a trading tool, the moving averages and Elliott and Fibonacci are great tools, but the market is always going to tell us what it wants to do. We may not like it, but it's going to tell us what it wants to do. And we get an option. And that option is to like change what we're thinking and go along with the market. Or if you already are going along with the market, enjoy the ride. So now, what can we expect for tomorrow? Well, being that these are broken and we're now up here and we've closed above it, my estimation is that we should continue higher. Now, again, having said that, here are our levels coming off. Of course, in order to totally negate the count, it's going to have to break below 12,953.50. When it starts breaking below that, then we're going to take another stand back and we're going to just determine what is going on. The only alternative that I can come up with right now is to continue a downside move, is that this level completed the ABC, and this is where that B would be here. It's a slight new high over what, no, it actually, it isn't. So it would be a slight failure here, but still. Then this would be wave one, and what we're doing is a wave two, which still could have upside. But right now, that's going to move into my alternate position. So the preferred I'm thinking right now is that this market is going to want to continue to go up. So where's it going to go? Well, again, here we are in trying to measure the A wave against a C wave. So those are going to be the relationship that we look at. The first one, remember, is that wave C is going to be 100% the length of wave A. That puts it right here, 13,492. So we'll call it 493, and you're going to go all the way up to 13,500. And it's still going to be absolutely perfect. And it fulfills a lot of the requirements for a C wave in an ABC structure. It goes up and it moves above the high of wave A, boom, gets it. And it is the most common relationship in terms of how long or where this should complete. So that's our first area right there. We've got nothing else really around it. So I'm just going to, you're going to build a zone that it could come to 90. That might be good. So it's going to be 90 to 30, 13,500, 13,505, any within those areas. And then it turns again, is likely going to be telling us that that could be complete. But again, remember, what I'm also looking for is the structure itself. It's, if indeed it's a C wave, it has to form in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It has to form 5 waves up. Wave 1, wave 2 down, wave 3 up, 4 down, 5 up. That's what it needs to form before all is said and done. So first level would be here. The second most common relationship is that it, wave C is equal to 0.618 of A, and that would put it here, and that would be an even bigger failure than what we just probably experienced if I had to count this as the entire completion point. So I would not be looking for that. It may take a pause here because it is Fibonacci and it should be provide some resistance. Not a great deal, but it should. Again, we'll find some resistance at this 0.236 of the larger move that we're looking for. It may find some resistance there. And turn and come back. In fact, today it got pretty close to that resistance and then turned lower. When it continues to break here, we get above there and our moving averages begin to point higher, then I'm going to be more convinced that we are going to get up into these levels. So beyond the first one, that wave C is 100% of wave A. The second, I'm not even going to qualify because it should not end there and then turn lower unless this is one and this is two. That case, yes, it would turn lower, but that's an alternate count. That's not going to be the preferred. The preferred is that it should just pause and go right on through all of these until we start breaking up to these levels. This might complete it. And then our next zone is right here, 1.236, 1.382. So wave C is equal to 1.236, the length of wave A, and 1.382, the length of wave A. And when those make it, that's just where we're going to end up. And then the third zone is all the way up here. This, again, I'm not totally expecting it, because this would be the first, these would be the second, the fourth, because this is the first is 100%, the second is 0.618. We've kicked that one out. And so, but we'll still count it as two. And then this would be three and this would be four. So we have four areas that under the guidelines and rules of Fibonacci and Elliott could contain a C wave. Okay. The second one, we're not basically considering because of where it's located. Now, the alternate that I just spoke of would be that the entire B wave of the intermediate fourth wave down, the correction down, completed here in a failure. And that would fit, and I'll tell you why, because of the intensity of the initial drop. If it had failed here and then only went down and we're sitting here, we still can consider to fail it, but I would need a lot more indications that that was the case. Being that it all went down to here, that gives some pretty good clues that could have killed it. So our alternate count is going to be that the B wave finished here and a slight failure, and now the market is indeed moving lower in a C wave. Now, what's going to keep that together? Basically, that the market does not come up. I mean, it literally could come all the way back up to there before it turns. But wave two cannot retrace more than wave one created. And so that if going above that level breaks the rule. And break the rule, then it's not that. And I am fairly a stickler for rules. You know, you may find many Elliotticians, quote unquote, that will allow for those. And when they're big rules, like wave two is correcting wave one. And so it can't overcorrect it and go above it or below it. Then it's no longer a corrective wave. And that's the same with wave four. Wave four is correcting wave three, but it can't overlap wave one, because if it does, well, then it's not a fourth wave. It's something else. So that's why, you know, we stop trying to figure that count and we take a look at the market to give, well, what possibilities can it have? So that's why we've come up with the two. My preferred is that it's A, B, and we're going to get a C wave. For whatever reason, folks, they want to buy this market. The selling was intense, but this buying was just as intense as the selling. And I was surprised because we came in this morning down big. The Dow was down more than 500 first thing this morning. Then all of a sudden it was like, no, sorry, ba-boom. And they just kind of went off to the moon with it. So be it. When we take a step back, we are able to figure out, well, what's the intent? And now we've got it. And again, I'm going to reiterate something that I've talked all along, because we seem to be in corrective phases more than we are in the impulse phase. And that is that corrections can take wild turns, can produce strange patterns, but they all fit within there are 13 different patterns, recognizable patterns that a corrective move can take, an ABC structure. You can get what we call a triangle in there. You can get a double ABC. You can get a triple ABC, and on and on and on. So there are 13 different, which makes them more difficult to count out and keeps you on your toes in terms of having moves like we did today go against it. So you got to take a step back and determine where and what's going on. So for tomorrow, my preferred count would be that we continue to move higher. If indeed we only get up into this area, okay? And this would be the 0.236, but this level, which we did get above today, may contain it, and then that's a 50% level. So there is resistance at 13,223. I would suspect, since we've already gone above it more than once, that we will do it again, and maybe in Globex, but I'd be looking for this area, if it 13,287 to 290, we'll call it. In fact, you're gonna have to let it go all the way up to that 200-day moving average. So wherever that happens to be sitting right now, market's not trading, it's sitting at 13,317. So this would be a level that we're gonna look for. If it can break above it, that's great. If it's gonna break above as a part of this C wave up, it should not spend a whole lot of time here. It should not have a problem. It just kind of goes, oh, okay, resistance, yeah, fine. Boom, and it goes through. 13,377 may provide a little bit more stiffer. And then of course we have this one. But if it's an up move, I would definitely look at to break that high and then that high as it goes up and finishes the C wave. Again, first level, second level, third level. The fourth one we're not considering. Now, alternate, if this is wave one, so this would come, we change that B to a one, and this ends up being a wave two, like, let's just help each other out here. And I'm gonna take this down to the 15 minute, and then we're gonna see how this is pretty impulsive. Granted, I could probably work this out to be a B wave in between there, but it's just very impulsive today. One, two, three, four, five. That would be one or A of two, B of two, and then what's all this garbage in between? Could be still part of an internal B wave, who knows? So we need to let the market work it out, and then we'll be able to take a look at it and put it together. But right now, I see more opportunity to the upside than I do to the downside. That all can change by the time we get to our computers tomorrow morning. But right now, this is what it looks like. So again, if we get up into these levels and it doesn't break and it turns and starts to head lower and starts to break below 13,160, I'm going to call it, it's then more than likely one, two, and we're coming off. So again, we need to pay very close attention to these structures. And you may have to take it down to your 5-minute chart so you can see what this looks like. If it's a 5-wave rally and followed by a 3-wave decline, your chances are that it's going to go up again. It's more than likely it's going to go up again. If it starts to break down and it formed an ABC up, well, then that's going to give you more strength that it's forming 5 down and then we're going to go down. Again, this becomes easier as you become more accustomed to Elliott Wave, or that you're more acquainted with using it intraday and checking against the structure of what the market is producing for us. So we have our upside, we have our downside. And I'm going to leave it there and wish everybody a really great trading day tomorrow. And the next update will be tomorrow, Thursday, May 20th.